a Russian military invasion.
2014, 16th of the May, 21st or 22nd, they already start to bombing the airport.
This is what life is like for a homeless thug.
And it's clear this city is really digging in for the worst.
This is actually incredible. These are the Ukrainian champions. This is something you'd never, ever see.
Immediately, I went to head coach and said, oh, mister, please, I need to go to Donetsk and take my family out from this city because I think it could be war.
It's really, for us, it was a nightmare. When you're losing your home city, your stadium, your fans, supports and everything, it's very difficult. Almost we started from zero, you know.
Some bomb come to Donbass Arena and exploded. I watch it and can't understand it. It's a heart of the Nets. It's not possible.
When you see these pictures, you're feeling empty inside because, and you also remember about this time when the stadium was full. It was wonderful, but now it's feeling empty inside.
As it became apparent, Shakhtar would not be returning home anytime soon. Many would wonder if, like other teams in Donetsk, the club could just fold. But it's clear the reason why they've survived through such difficulty.
Shakhtar will be always. And that's the truth. If you have president like that, like our president, if you know him very well, you must understand that he is full in love in this club, in this city. And to leave Shakhtar in more difficult moment in the history of the club, he will not do it, never.
Shakhtar playing Champions League, we won a lot of trophies in Ukraine, and it's all about president.
If, for example, another club with another president, I don't believe that it will exist anymore.
Kiev is the home of Shakhtar. The Ukrainian champion has been based in the capital for the last 5 years despite playing in Lviv and now Kharkiv. Players live throughout the city and spend most of their week here at this 50-year-old Olympic site before traveling for home games.
I'm sure that we are only one club who is living in this kind of condition and doing this kind of result.
As a new signing, for me it was a bit weird that you come to club and you don't play in your home, but it's start to be normal for us.
For me, go to Kharkiv and go to Milan or go to Manchester, it's the same, you know, it's the same for my budget, the same for my time, it's all the same.
Every time when you play at home, you must go by flight. It's 1 hour, 1 hour, 1 hour, 1 hour, and sometimes in 1 week we make 6 times flight.
So this is our second house, you know. We live here for a long time. But the good way we have like our private airplane, that's a good one because you can sleep, you can, you know, lay down, you can listen to your music, and nobody disturb you, and have good food. But in the end of the season, you get tired, you know, yeah. It's not easy.
This is reality for Shakhtar, home games away from home. They may sell out for big matches, but this is a league match on Friday night in Kharkiv. Just to give you an idea of how empty the stadium is, this is the ultra section for tonight. It's almost unfathomable to me. It's a Champions League team, a team with this much history, this many trophies, that's forced out of their home and is still somehow successful. It's mind-blowing.
It's difficult to understand how we make this kind of result in this situation, but you know, how you say in English, what doesn't kill you make you stronger, no? And something special is also here.
At this moment, today, we have, let's say, two dreams. You know. One, it's to win Champions League. And the second one, it's to return back to Donetsk.